How's it going, Matters? Today we're playing Dark Souls. You may have seen tons of YouTubers do this. Maybe PewDiePie, stripping from Yogscast, you never know. But I'm going to be doing this video now. Haha. So let's get
perhaps
into it.
You've seen it. Maybe in a dream.
Oh.
A murky, forgotten land.
There you go, you're right there, folks. It's raining. Hey, new. Ha! He face planned.
A place.
Okay, so I'm skipping past that cutscene because it takes a while to do. This is going to be a full Let's Play. Callum and George will be in it, preferably not at the same time. So here we are, this is our character. We're not nothing special, we're just a man who's been cursed with this, this thing called the Hollowing. I'm only a fan of Dark Souls 2. I absolutely hate Dark Souls 1. Just because it was too hard and I couldn't get anywhere. But this, I've actually completed the game on the second playthrough. So, yeah. Now, here we can make our character, which is this guy. It's not going to be anything special, so we'll be back in a sec when I made my character. Oh yeah, and there's old ladies that are really pain in my ass. So I'm naming my person, so I'm just going to call him... Sexair. Genome. Yay. So this is kind of what I came up with. Yep, so I'm going to be playing as a knight. I'm going to be having the petrified something as a gift. Because if we're lucky, there's this little nest at the beginning where we can get a really cool item right from the start. Shut up.
Here for the same reason.
Shut up! I skipped. So here we go now. This is our character. This is our sword. We haven't got a shield or anything. But if I say we've only got one sword. We've got some life gems here. These are like our health regain. We can use them now, but I prefer to leave them. Before you start the game, you always have to collect these. Now, because when you die in the game, you turn into something called a hollow, like it was at the beginning. Except we won't be wearing them hooded clothes anymore. You can kill these old women. To get some more human effigies, but there's not all the time they'll drop one, so it's not a good idea to kill them. Plus, I'd recommend not killing them, because one of them lets you reset your stats, just in case you got nothing. Now these are bonfires, if you don't know already, if you haven't watched anyone. These are like checkpoints. Eventually, you start getting things called Estus Flasks, damn it. And with the Estus Flasks, they heal you even more better than Life Gems. You start off with one Life Gem, and then you end up gradually getting more. So, yeah. Right. I'm going to go to the bird thing, because I'll be back in a sec. Okay, now, there's a thing down there. That is the sex change coffin. So I'm a man right now. So if I went in there, I'd turn into a woman. There's a creature down there as well. There is two. If you kill them both, the woman that looks after the old ladies will give you a weapon. This game is all about the backstabs, by the way. So if you get a chance to backstab someone, I would recommend you taking it. So yeah. Okay, so here we are. This is the nest. I'll let them talk if they can, if they will. Here we go. Always good to kick down that ladder, by the way, just so you get a shortcut. So now you're going to do, you're going to go to your infantry. Now they take petrified somethings, and they also take silken smooth stones. So it's always good to use these. But when you have more than one, if you just click leave, and then click one, and then click OK. Always do just one at a time before you go, or you just get something different, I think. I hate them. So I'll put this up now. We've got twinkling tardenites knives already. Shut up! Don't want to do it. Silky smooth. It's always good to have twinkling tardenites because you can upgrade weapons, like the really good weapons. I think stuff that you make on this take petrified bone, dragon bones or something. They're profound dragon bones, that's it. And they're pretty hard to find. So, yeah. Yeah, so now I look at them online, you're going to see like tons of these, and there's going to be like covered in blood. We look at one now, look. Don't give up, stay calm. Never! Here we go. I can see clearly now, the rain has gone. Majula. Mamajula, Mamajula, Mamajula. So yeah, so Callum and George will be on this. Probably at the same time, probably not, it depends. It's hard to find the friend at the beginning unless you have the name engraved ring which you can buy from this house. As you can see at the bottom, it says that little symbol and 206. They're souls. And souls is money in this game. And this should be a cat, like this person here.
Oh, and one. So,
yeah. Sir. This cat. You can buy stuff. And there's this thing here called the Name Engraved Ring. This helps you link up with your friends and that easier. Because if you have a certain ring with, like, say, the goddess of love in it, because you could pick out a gods with the ring. And if you and your mate have the same god on, you've got more chance of finding the god. Your friend. Now, this is a blacksmith's house. Each house is locked until you get a key. I know where the key is, so don't worry. Up here is a shrine, as you can see. It tells you exactly how many deaths have happened since the game has come out. That is a lot of deaths worldwide. But you say, yeah, talk to this guy, spam his chat. So yeah, I'll be back in a sec as soon as you stop talking. Now, it's a good idea to talk to this dude and spam his talking out, because he actually joined the Blue Coven. So you join the Blue Covenant at the beginning because it makes the game easier. So now, as you can see, like, right there is a Covenant symbol. There is one over there, if you can see right at the little archway there. That thing lets you into another Covenant, but it makes the game harder. So I wouldn't recommend this. So yeah, talk to this woman here. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Yes. Okay, now she's giving us an Estus flask. Now this is the bestest way of healing. So if you go, just go and equip that. I'm also going to equip my human efficiency. And I'm also going to use this soul we've got. Now you find souls like this around the world. It's a pretty good idea to pick them up. There are a bit better ones and bigger ones. Now, you only start off with one Estus Flask as well. But we can upgrade the Estus Flask. You find shards around the world. So, you see like this world here? It's going to go, yep. That falls, that opens. Estus Flask shard. So then, right at the beginning, we've got... Oh, hello. Well, you're not moving. Right at the beginning we've got two Estus flasks. Yay. If Callum was online, I would be recording with him now. But he's not online. George has actually gone to the hospital because of his wrist. If you saw his wrist in... shut up! If you saw his arm in the challenge we did, it was in a bandage or something. Now, okay, so we just upgraded our SS fast, sorry. So that makes we have two now. But yeah, so his arm is badly hurt or something at SS hospital, and they might have to put it in a cast. So that might stop him from doing a couple of videos. But yeah. Okay, so you start off with a torch, I think. Do you start off with a torch? Yeah, so see that 5 minute symbol? That's a torch. You can get, every time you pick up a torch, it adds time onto your torch. My other save has an hour's worth of a torch on it. Just because I don't use it. So yeah, this is a good idea to get a chest. I think you get a rustic coin here. I don't know what to do with them. I really don't. Might Callum might. But, yep, so this way, we're going to our first place, which is called the Forest of the Fallen Giants, I think it is. So, it's going to open this. It takes its time to open. So we're just going to wait. Let me in. Yeah, so if you want to block, you have to jaw wheel, or you get a shield. Now, I haven't got a shield at all, I think. Yeah, no shield. Gonna cross this bridge. There's something down here. Oh, there you go, it's a chest. There's an item down there, but you have to go round. It's a human effigy. So I am sorry about the quality of the gaming videos. They will be getting better, I promise you. I've said this a couple of times, but they will be better. I will be getting the capture card soon, as soon as the wires come for Callum. Because he said he's got his capture card and he's just getting some wires, and as soon as the wires come, he said I can have it. So I can record better. Now, we've just got a Homer Bone. They're a thing that lets you fast travel back to a bonfire. But because we haven't got anything here yet, it's best to go to the bonfire before we even use it. I don't particularly use Homer Bones unless I really need to. Duh. Come on. Oh god, oh god, oh god. I wasn't ready. I wasn't ready. He wasn't ready.
Oh, she wasn't ready. She wasn't ready. Hey.
Oh god. Okay, so we've got an item over here, and right next to us is a bonfire. So we're going to go check that bonfire out now. Now, the thing about bonfires is, if you sit and rest at them, it respawns all the enemies. Enemies only respawn for a certain amount of times. So, like, say, I think sometimes they can spawn for like 15 minutes, 15 times, sorry, and that's it. But it is a pain in the ass because you're going to have to rest the bonfires at some point for like Estus, so you can recharge Estus fast. Or like magical spells. Because you can use magic in this game, but because I'm a strength build right now, I am too dumb to use anything mythical or uses faith. But my other save, I've actually leveled up my stats, my strength build, to the point where I don't need to upgrade it anymore. So I've been upgrading my mythical stuff, so my magic stuff, so I still don't know how to use it properly yet. I should hopefully be using magic in this Let's Play as well. Oh god! Where did he come from? So we're not going to use our Estus Flask yet. We're going to use some Life Gems. Just because they're probably one of the bestest ways to heal up. Just going to use two here. Now, there are some enemies up here. And they're pretty fun, he says. Now, so there's a dude there by the tree. It's best not to attack him yet. But if you do, he gives you a really nice sword. That I absolutely love. You'll find these in the game everywhere. all that everywhere. They're like spread out in the game. There's I think there's about, well, I've only seen three of them, but they're spread out in the game. They won't attack you unless you attack them. They're kind of people who, you know, they're looking, they're waiting for the perfect fight or something. Yeah, I wouldn't recommend attacking him if you don't think you can take him. I don't think I will attack him yet. He lied. Yeah, so I'm just going to go up here. It's always good to take out some enemies. Like, there's enemies around the world. If you can, it's always good to take them out. Because they can give you souls. Well, that's what I found. Oh yeah, there's another thing I don't like about this game compared to the first one. The first one I found was really hard and I didn't like it and I couldn't do it. But the thing I liked about the first one was like, ragdoll! There's no ragdoll here, because in the first one, if I walked over a dead body, he'd ragdoll everywhere.
A little flashback.
It doesn't happen in this one, and it kind of ruined it for me. But this Dark Souls, I do say, is better than the first Dark Souls. Ow. All right then, sir. You asked for it now. Ah! I pick up this item, which is a short bow, which is always a good thing to have. Gonna heal. I was gonna jump down, but I don't wanna risk it. Ah! Oh, there's a shortcut here. I was gonna say, screw it. So if you don't think you can take him, don't take that person down. Mistake! I made a mistake, I hit him! I don't wanna do this! Okay, idea. I've got an idea. Let him attack first. Yeah. Okay. Now, I want his sword. Hopefully, it'll drop his sword. You can get his armor. It's like a random drop, but this one I've only seen, I've only ever given his sword. One of them gives you a halberd, which is a really nice halberd. Now, I kind of want this sword, because it has electric damage on it, so it'll start doing electric damage to any enemy I hit. So it's always good to have that. Oh god! Oh, it's going, guys.
Huh. Finish him!
Got him!
It paid off!
I think for that I'm taking a drink of the Estus flask. Here we go, the Hide Knight sword. This is a great sword, this is. Ah! I'm too weak to handle it. It takes 10 strength. Right now I've only got 8. Oh, it's dexterity, sorry. This is not fun. Not fun at all. Oh, this is a two-way path. There's always a sign somewhere here saying, don't go away, there's another person here. So I always tend to go here, attack these. I've just attacked them. I've just assaulted them too. They were having some drinks, and now I'm just killed them. So there's a person here, look. So it's always good to try and go around and try and backstab him. Now, this game is all about the backstabs. Anything critical that will hurt someone is what this game's really about. Oh, hello, I didn't see us too, as he's looking at the camera. So he's dead. I'm doing pretty better than I usually do. I usually die around about here now. There's always someone here chucking shit at me. See? You get around here, there's a person that lobs fire bombs. That's never nice. Woo! Hello. My stamina. Alright, I use the life gem. Well, not use that, I've just picked up a life gem. Now, it's always good to take out some enemies, like I said. It gives you souls. Like, right now, I've got 4,000 souls, so I can level up a bit. This game takes death like a punishment. Like, unless you've got a certain ring, which is called the Ring of Life Protection, you lose every single one of your souls. But you've got to go... It's one of those things, if you lose your soul and you turn to a hollow, but the souls you can retrieve, and you retrieve them, and you can retrieve them, but if you die and the souls are still out there, you can't get them back. They're gone, and you have to try and get the one you've just lost. Which is a pretty annoying thing. So I'm going to talk to this lady, because it's always good to talk to her, because if you go over here, she's got a key. So this is the blacksmith in Medjula's key, so you're always going to want to pick that up.
Thanks.
So yeah, I'm going to be back, I'm just going to travel to Medjula, and I'll be back in a sec. Okay, if you didn't know, bonfires fast travel, and there's a bonfire in Medjula, and I didn't activate it. So now I've got to walk from here, because this is the quickest way, there's no enemies, to get to Medjula. I'm back in Medjula. Thank the Lord. So I'm just going to activate this bonfire. Probably a good thing to activate that the first time. So it's always good to give this man, buy that key from that lady, because you give it to him.
Who are you?
Oh. So you open it. There you go. So now, you have to go away and come back, but that blacksmith will start working there, and you can repair weapons, because that stuff kind of breaks as well. And life protection rings, it's always good to keep him up, because he's the easiest one to get to. Now, I want to use that sword, this High Knight sword, but you can see, one of my things is red. So that means I have to upgrade my dexterity to 10, which is 8. Now, you can level up by talking to this woman here. Before I know, it's the only way to level up. So if I'm going to level my dexterity twice. So now, that's where my soul's gone. And now, I can use this sword. Now, this is the High Knight sword. It does electric damage. It's a really nice sword. I haven't got a shield. So what I'm going to be doing is, right now, I'm going to draw wheel. There you go. If you get two of the same weapon, by the way, as well, you can also proper draw wheel. You hold Y down, it just it changes stance, and then you can end up doing better stuff. So yeah, I'll meet you back to the place. That we just were. Guys, I am sorry, but we're out of time for this video. If you want, stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you in a bit, guys.